What's going on, guys? Alan B here, and hopefully you guys notice a very improved quality difference. First off, maybe through the YouTube quality selector if everything goes well, but also just in general. Now, I'm gonna be very honest with you guys. It's very rare when I use a dedicated camera for this channel. I do have a point-and-shoot camera that does do video. It's one of the Canon PowerShot point-and-shoots that were really popular in 2011, and it takes good video, don't get me wrong, but battery life isn't the greatest. I don't know what happened to my SD card that went with the camera, etc., etc. So my main camera for the longest time has been this. This is my iPhone 5S, 32 gig. I got this a couple years ago, but it's as with any phone, really. After 2 years, you start to feel the datedness, and I have started to feel the datedness, especially with the screen size, because my hands are pretty big, honestly, in my opinion. And yeah, this screen just wasn't doing it for me. Just other things in general, as well as I wanted to go back to Android, mainly so I can get text on my computer and control my Nexus player and stuff like that. So, what I'm getting last week, in fact, it's going to be exactly 1 week come tomorrow. No, actually, it's today. I forgot. We got it on a Friday. I got this, the Samsung Galaxy S7 32 gig in black from AT&T, because that's the best carrier that works in my area. I'm coming from US Cellular. If anyone is from, Illinois and Virginia area, around that region. And yeah, it's just I wanted to go for something bigger, and going out of state is kind of a hassle with US Cellular, so with AT&T, we've been very happy with it so far. And yeah, so hopefully you guys noticed it. I think I'm recording at 1440p, if I'm not mistaken. And so far, everything looks great on my end. Of course, I have this little guy right here. This is a old BlackBerry charger. And yeah, supposedly autofocusing on the S7 is supposed to be really, really good. As you can see right there, very fast, which is always very welcome. So, you guys, hopefully you guys can see a lot more detail on that versus my 5S. Granted, I do have some lighting in here for right there and right there. But, yeah, so hopefully everything is seen very well. Another thing I did get also, kind of speaking about this little guy, is I got a Samsung wireless charger right there. And once I hooked it up to a fast charger, it worked just fine. But when it comes to ports like this, and then I also have an LG one right here, it's bigger. For whatever reason, these two didn't work very well at all. So I just used a Samsung fast charger, and it works perfectly even with the case on. I also have a case, another case right here actually, the Spigen, what is it, Ultra Hybrid, which is a very clear case. I wanted to kind of show off my phone a bit more. But the reason I'm not using this right now is because it does a really weird bubble effect on my the back of my screen, since the Galaxy S7, if you don't know, like the S6, is made out of both sides are made out of glass. So for whatever reason, this case doesn't really like to work well for that. So there's that. One of the things that actually kind of inspired me to do this, because I did a few takes of this already, both a few days ago and now, is I'm actually watching IMNC. It's my natural color on Ustream. He's streaming live, and he's kind of sort of inspiring me to do this today. But yeah, so hopefully you guys enjoy the content, or at least enjoy the new upgraded camera. As you can see right here, I have a few other videos hopefully in the process. Both are laptops. I have the iBook G3, which I still need to do. I know I unboxed that a while ago, and I mean, it's a really cool laptop again, but just certain things in terms of gaming I wanted to show you guys hasn't been working out too well, so that's been kind of on the back burner. As well as I want to do a video on this thing, my Sager laptop, which some of you gamers out there might think Sager is a really great brand. I don't doubt their newer gaming line is, but this laptop, spec-wise, it's not bad, but quality-wise, it's a lot to be desired. So, yeah, hopefully I'll be doing videos on both of those. I also want to do another desk tour. I did a desk tour, and that's actually on my 5S right now, but certain things, I just want to redo it, especially with this new upgraded camera. Especially because before, you couldn't even see that computer with my 5S. Yeah, there's still a lot of black parts, although I can still see that pretty well. That's actually my Xbox controller adapter thing. But you couldn't see that computer very well at all before. Now you can see it fairly well. It's my streaming computer, my first custom build. Alright, so I wanted to go ahead and give a very quick first off outdoor demonstration. It is overcast, by the way, right now, but I just want to kind of show you the outside with this camera. I also wanted to tell you about a few other things I just want your guys' opinion on. As you can probably tell, I'm recording both of these clips in 1440p, and my concern is my computer. I'm just going to go ahead and show you these flowers, like a professional YouTuber and everything. But, yeah, my concern is that I have a computer with an i5 on it, which already isn't that great for video editing. It's not bad. It gets the job done, and there's certainly worse computers you can use. But it's definitely going to be chugging along with 1440p. So if it works well, I'll keep it like this. But if not, would you guys want to see 60 FPS 1080p? Because me personally, I'm still kind of iffy on it. But if you guys want to see it, then I'll oblige, but again, just viewing preference, I don't really care too much for unless it's a video game or something like a sports type video. But anyway, just wanted that quick opinion. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.